فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Wait, wait, you guys wait. Other brothers. If it was Muslim I was reading right now and it was like this, I would never said that. But why Bukhari? Because Muslim didn't chapter his book. And Imam Muslim did not make the tabweebat of his book. Who did it for him? It's a joint effort. Some scholars, they say, Nawawi did it, but he's not alone on that. Abu al-Abbas al-Qurtubi also did it with him. Ibn al-Arabi also did it with him. So it's a joint effort. Everybody added their changings and addings. And Muslim did not do bab, 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 bab. Muslim only made kitab, 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 books, 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 books. The person who did those babs for Sahih Muslim are who? Nawawi, Abu al-Abbas al-Qurtubi and others. They came together, they did it together like that. As for Bukhari, his kitab, his tabweebat are all his own works. Does that make sense? And his babs are basically there for a knowledge he's trying to extract. ولذلك إمام البخاري الإمام الإمام ولذلك الإمام البخاري الإمام أبي داود الإمام البخاري and أبي داود are the only two from the six scholars of hadith according to Ibn Taymiyyah who are مجتهد مطلق. Do you see my point? Bukhari is a مجتهد مطلق. أبو داود السجستاني صاحب السنن is also a مجتهد مطلق. Based on what Ibn Taymiyyah said. He said the other rest are not mujtahid mutlaq. That's the ikhtiyar of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah alayhi rahmatullah. Lian al-Bukhari, if you read his tabweebat, and inshallah, if Allah gives us chance to go up through other chapters of his sahih, fiqh, fiqh. So he's from the muhaddithin who are fuqaha. Fuqaha. So here, loving the Prophet, since we were mentioning shu'ab iman, branches of iman, this one would have been better if it was a bit earlier. But inshallah ta'ala khair. Loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is from the iman. Not is only from the iman. It is min a'zami wa ajalli shu'ab al-iman. It's from the greatest and the most noblest branches of iman. Naam, haddathana.
Qala akhbarana shu'aybun. Qala
haddathana. First person is who?
Abu Zinad.
Bukhari started, who's the sheikh?
Oh, haddathana Abu al-Yaman.
Abu al-Yaman, his name is al-Hakam ibn Nafi' al-Himsi. Hayya, shu'ayb.
قال أخبرنا شعيب.
شعيب's name is ابن أبي حمزة. شعيب ابن أبي حمزة.
قال حدثنا أبو الزناد.
أبو الزناد's name is عبد الله بن ذكوان.
عن الأعرج.
هيا سعد وس أعرج. What's his name of أعرج؟ لا that's أعمش. أعرج. هيا.
عبد الرحمن بن ذكوان.
عبد الله بن ذكوان is أبو الزناد.
عبد الرحمن بن هرمز.
عبد الرحمن بن هرمز نعم. أعرج his name is عبد الرحمن بن هرمز صح جميل good.
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه.
أبو هريرة's name was what? What did we choose? عبد الرحمن. عبد الرحمن بن صخر الدوسي who brought him into Islam. طفيل بن عمرو الدوسي brought him into Islam. أبو هريرة. طفيل بن عمرو الدوسي نعم.
أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said what?
هو الذي نفسي بيده.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He is swearing by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. We don't even need for the Prophet to swear by Allah. We will take it from him regardless of it. Sahih? So the Prophet ﷺ, he swore by Allah. He said, I swear by the Lord in which my soul is in his hand. This is an evidence to show that Allah has a hand that befits his majesty. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, go kitab Tirmidhi, Sunan Tirmidhi. Go to the hadith. Go to the hadith Babu Fadli As-Sadaqah. Tirmidhi has what? Babu Fadli As-Sadaqah. Tirmidhi has it. And he brings the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna Allah ya'khudhu biyameenihi. When the person gives the sadaqah, Allah takes it with his right. Tirmidhi, as soon as he brings that narration, at the bottom he starts to talk about the issue of Allah's characteristics and attributes. And he mentions that the people who say Allah's hand in the hadith, بيمينه, or anywhere it's found in the athar, or the textual evidence, whether it be the Quran or the Sunnah, who say it means quwwah, he says that this is a tafsir jahmi. This is the belief of the jahmiyyah. And today you find the Asha'ira, a group who have deviated from the path of Ahlul Sunnah, who claim that the hand of Allah means what? It means quwwah. It can't mean quwwah. How can it mean quwwah? It can't mean quwwah. وَلِذَلِكَ there's a full explanation that we are doing on the characteristics and the attributes of Allah. Explain the book, سُنَنِ الدَّارُ قُطْنِيُّ الصِّفَاتِ لِلْإِمَامِ دَارُ قُطْنِيُّ His book. So I brought all the narrations over there. نعم.
وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِهِ لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ وَالِدِهِ وَوَلَدِهِ
The Prophet said, لَا يُؤْمِنُ That a person is not a believer. حَتَّى أَكُونَ Until I become أَحَبَّ More beloved to him. مِنْ وَالِدِهِ From his parents. وَوَلَدِهِ And his children. So you need to love the Prophet ﷺ more than your parents, and you have to love the Prophet ﷺ more than your children. You need to. So the benefit we take from the hadith is number one, that we can swear, the benefits that we take from the hadith is number one, that we can swear by Allah's name without having to need, no one's telling us to do it, we don't have to do it. We can say Wallahi. Are you with me? Without any reason, we can, based on this hadith. But not, don't do it frequently. Somalis, they get happy now, look at them happy. Pass me the ball, Wallahi. I'll give you the ball, okay, Wallahi. That's no need for that. I saw a white boy, in London. He plays football with Somalis, and every time he talks, he says to you, "Wallahi, wallahi, wallahi." He's not even a Muslim. So I looked at him and said, "Where did you get this from?" He said, "I play football with Somalis." I was slightly happy that the Somalis influenced him. That's good, right? In a way, they influenced him. No, that's good. I was a bit happy with that. But the point is, using Wallahi like that is not what I mean. And I don't mean that. But it means that sometimes when you need to say Wallahi to prove your point, even though you're not lying, but just to say it is permissible, like the Prophet did alayhi salatu wasalam. Also the benefit that we take from this hadith is that you do not give precedence to the Prophet's guidance over anybody else's guidance. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ Don't give precedence to anybody over Allah and His Messenger. Whether it be your children, whether it be your parents, Allah and His Messenger take precedence over everybody else. Hayya faddal. You know what they said about Sheikh Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i? Sheikh Muqbil never had no sons. He only had daughters. Allah never gave him sons. And I read from his biography, alayhi rahmatullahi, that Sheikh Muqbil used to live in a hard life. The place he was at, they didn't have money. ولذلك there's a book he wrote called Dhammul Mas'ala. Like, don't beg the people. Wallahi, Sheikh Muqbil was, his life is amazing. He didn't have a lavish lifestyle and whatnot. And he said that used to bring happiness to my heart and joy to my heart and was better to me than nine boys, for me to have nine boys and for me to just have this one thing. This one thing is better to me than is what? When I sit down and I say, Haddathana. And all my pain and my suffer would all drop from my heart the minute I sit down to teach a kitab of hadith and I open, I say, Haddathana. Whenever I start saying that, he says, my heart becomes na'am. And that's how the person finds joy in knowledge. So, brothers, don't go. I can see some of them are moving. It's a train. Well, this train is not going to stop for no one. You have to just make sure you're in it. Don't jump out the window. Yeah, don't try to stop the train. Don't try to kill the driver. We're going, brothers. We have to go.
In the same chapter, narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu, the same hadith but with a slight addition at the end, narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, none of you will have faith till he loves me more than his father, his children, and all mankind.
Okay.
حدثنا يعقوب بن إبراهيم قال حدثنا
يعقوب بن إبراهيم الدورقي is his name. هيه.
حدثنا ابن عليا.
ابن عليا his name is إسماعيل ابن إبراهيم ابن عليا. نعم.
عن عبد العزيز بن صهيب عن أنس رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ح
Here the ha'im is what? Tahweel al-Isnad is called. Bukhari is trying to move from one chain to another chain. And Imam Muslim does that very often. So the ha' here is what? It's tahweel. Are you with me? He's on a chain and he diverts from that chain, he turns from that chain to another chain. The reason why, and inshallah ta'ala, we're going to see a mas'ala, a very good beneficial point from here, that Imam Bukhari is trying to do here. Are you, we're going to see it soon. So Imam Muslim narrated it from two people. He narrated it from who? Ya'qub ibn Ibrahim. He also narrated it from Adam ibn Iyas. Now those two, so Bukhari needs from two sheikhs. So before he gets to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam statement, he will say حدثنا يعقوب بن إبراهيم قال حدثنا ابن علية عن عبد العزيز بن صهيب عن أنس بن مالك ح. He won't say the Prophet statement yet, and then he will say حدثنا داود حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة عن أنس قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So these are the two sanad I go to the Prophet with. Pay attention. فائدة.
حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين.
Here this hadith, here we already mentioned what it means, but there's a benefit in this hadith. When you study مصطلح الحديث, who here has studied the science of hadith? Put your hand up if you studied science of hadith. Okay, there's a book written by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. It's called what? It's called Nukhbat al-Fikr. He also explained his book. He called it what? Nuzhat al-Nadar fi tawdih Nukhbat al-Fikr. Ibn Hajar. What he's talking about, taqsimat al-hadith bi'atibari wusulihi ilayna, categorizing the hadith, how it reached us. He'd categorize it into mutawatir and then ahad. And then within the ahad, he categorized it into three. Mashhur, Aziz, and Gharib, right? Those of you who studied it. This narration here right now, it falls under the second type of the Ahad. The first one was what? Mashhur. The second one is what? Aziz is what? Aziz Marwi Fawqa. Aziz is Marwi. Is Marwiyun from what? Two. So two companions narrated from the Prophet, two tabi'in, ila muntaha sanad, until the chain of narration finishes. It has to be two. So now let's look at this narration if it's two. How many companions narrated from the Prophet? Two. Who's it? Abu Hurairah and who?
Anas
ibn Malik. So two have companions. Now we need to know, from Abu Hurairah's side, it doesn't become Aziz. We don't need to go that way anymore. We go through Anas's side. Because Anas, two people narrated from him. Who are the two narrated from him? And that's where Bukhari brought the ha for you. Who narrated it from him? Here, Qatada narrated it from him. And here, who narrated it from him? Suhaib. Sahih? Qatada ibn Da'amah al-Sadusi and Suhaib. So I have two tabi'een. Who narrated from this tabi'i? Two people. One is Shu'bah ibn Hajjaj, Abu Bistam al-Ataki, and the next one is Abdul Aziz ibn Ulayya. Sahih? Are we together? This is Aziz. This hadith has an additional meaning like in the Abu Hurairah's narration didn't have, which was what? وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ, and all of the people. All of the people. The other narration of Abu Hurairah doesn't have all of the people. It finishes as what? حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ وَلَدِهِ وَوَالِدِهِ. This. Anas ibn Malik is what? مِنْ وَلَدِهِ وَوَالِدِهِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. هيا. And this is وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. The hadith of the riwayah of Abu Huraira, it not being there, there's no need for it because it's atful ammi ala al khasi. If your mom and your dad, you're going to love the Prophet more than them and they're meant to be the closest to you, then of course everybody else is going to be the same. So.
Chapter, the sweetness of faith. Narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever possesses the following three qualities will have the sweetness of faith. The one to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam become dearer than anything else. The one who loves a person and he loves him only for the sake of Allah. And the one who hates to revert to atheism, disbelief, as he hates to be thrown into the fire.
Babu halawat al-Iman.
And Imam al-Bukhari here chaptered the sweetness of Iman. Iman is sweet. It's something that can be tasted. But if your taste buds have become, if you eat something that's another flavor, can you really taste the sweet stuff? Now you've kind of messed up your taste buds. So if you really guys want to have the sweetness of Iman is sweet, but it's the taste buds. There's nothing wrong with the iman, and the halawa is still in there. It's just you messed up your taste buds. ولذلك ابن تيميه says ان في الدنيا جنه من لم يدخلها لم ان في الدنيا جنه من لم يدخلها لم يدخل جنه الاخره. In this dunya there is a jannah. Anyone who doesn't enter the jannah of this dunya will not enter the jannah of the hereafter. Also the salaf, they used to say, what did they used to say? لو يعلم الملوك وابناء الملوك ما نحن فيه من الخير والنعيم والسرور لجادلونا عليه بالسيوف. صح. If the kings and the children of the kings were to know the joy and the happiness which we have, they would shither their sword, they would come over and they would try to take that happiness out of our chests. And they would try to steal it from us. What's the happiness that he's referring to? By the way, when he was saying this, that he was dipping his bread in the ocean because it was so hard. And he's eating it from the ocean. They have no meat, they have nothing to eat. It's halawatul iman. It's the sweetness of iman. So Bukhari is telling you, babu chapter, halawatul iman, the sweetness of iman. Where the person feels happy, even though he's physically struggling, even though he's going through hard times, you can never see it from his face. Iman, sweetness is received. Naam.
حدثنا محمد بن المثنى قال حدثنا عبد الوهاب.
محمد بن المثنى is Abu Musa al-Anazi. Naam.
قال حدثنا عبد الوهاب.
عبد الوهاب is ابن عبد المجيد الثقفي. نعم.
قال حدثنا أيوب عن أبي قلابة عن أنس رضي.
أبو أيوب, his name is ابن أبي تميمة السجستاني. ابن أيوب السختياني, sorry. ابن أبي تميمة السختياني, نعم.
عن أبي قلابة.
عبد الله ابن يزيد الجرمي.
عن أنس رضي الله عنه.
أنس ابن مالك خادم رسول الله, the prophet's slave.
عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
That the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
ثلاث من كن فيه وجد حلاوة الإيمان.
Anyone who has these three in him, he has tasted the sweetness of iman.
أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما.
Allah and His Messenger are more beloved to him than anything besides them. Allah and His Messenger are what you love the most. So meaning, I love Allah, سبحانه وتعالى. I love the remembrance of Allah. Whenever Allah's name is mentioned, my heart finds joy. I love Him. I just, you know, when a guy is in love, he always wants to talk about the person he's in love with, right? Even things that he wants to always make the conversation about that, right? What did the poet say? أُقَبِّلُ ذَا الْجِدَارِ وَذَا الْجِدَارِ وَبَا الْجِدَارُ شَفَقْنَ قَلْبِي وَلَكِنْ لِمَا سَكَنَ الدِّيَارِ, right? There was a woman he used to love. This man used to love this woman so much. So he went and kissed the walls. Kissed the wall. And they said to him, what are you kissing the wall for? And he said, I don't love the walls, and I'm not in love with the walls. I'm in love with the person who used to live behind these walls. So, I love the woman who used to live here before. So the love of a person makes you want to talk about them all the time. But if I tell you Allah said, and you go, oh man, not this again. Youngsters, when your parents say, today I'm going to tell you about Allah and His Messenger, oh, again. But then one cartoon comes on, so he's laughing. Or football game comes on, so it's like he got electrocuted. He's standing there like, does it move? Are you with me? Are you there? Wallahi, if one thing shows you that shaitan exists, anybody who says to you, I don't believe shaitan exists, I can prove it to them. I can give them empirical evidences, empirical, tangible evidences. Just take a little child, put music on for him. New child, he just starts moving his leg. Put Quran on and a hadith on. The kid goes, Sah? Shaitan doesn't exist, wallahi. Wallahi, he exists. He exists, not only does he exist, his efforts and his hard work is clear. It's there. You can see it right there. SubhanAllah. So if the person loves Allah, you can see it on them. Whenever Allah is mentioned, they stand up. Like, okay, yeah. I wanna know what happened. They're interested, intrigued. But a person who doesn't love Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, when it's mentioned, he's like, that's when his sleep starts. What did the brother say? He said, Akhi, whenever I lose something, I go into salah. That's when I find it. Whenever I lose a key or I forgot where I displaced my stuff, I go sunnah. I don't know where it is. Meaning he's saying to you, in my salah, I have no khushu. He's telling you clearly, I go wanderer, I go My brothers, is the reality of the matter is, if you love Allah, it means that His remembrance is what you love. It's also that His remembrance and Him being spoken about, just your joy and happiness, that's where it comes from. Naam. You love a person, but you only love them for the sake of Allah. Loving a Muslim, but for the sake of Allah, is an honor. No worldly reasons. No other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I love you for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَن يُحِبَّ الْمَرْءَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. The reason why you love them is because they obey Allah. They listen to the one that you love. If you love Allah, the one who is listening to the one you love them. Sahih. Are you with me? No. And he stays away from what you know Allah told him to stay away from. You just can't stop but loving that individual. And we mentioned before, إِنَّ مِنْ أَوْثَقُ عُرَى الْإِيمَانِ الْبُغْضُ فِي اللَّهِ وَالْحُبُّ فِي اللَّهِ. One of the highest branches of Iman is loving for the sake of Allah and hating for the sake of Allah. Naam.
وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ كَمَا يَكْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ.
That the person hates going for disbelief and not believing in Allah the way he hates to be thrown into hellfire. If somebody gave you the choice right now to go into the fire and to become a disbeliever, you might choose to go into the fire. You might give that choice. How much you hate disbelief. Ah. And now it's sad because you hear a lot of Muslims, they سَمَّعُونَ لِلْكَذِبِ أَكَّالُونَ لِلْسُّعْتِ. ما معنى سَمَّعُونَ لِلْكَذِبِ? They love to listen to lies. Are you listening? What are the lies that people love to listen to? I believe this falls under it. People love to watch comedy and whatnot, and you know, stand-up comedians who you know everything he's saying is a lie. But what I mean by that is, they listen to atheism propaganda. You have people like Richard Dawkins and Lawrence Krauss and Stephen Hawking and people like that. Your ears attentive, you want to listen to everything they have to say. Hating that what they are upon and what they're calling to. Because wallahi, I've realized one thing, brothers. And I'm right now, as I said, I was telling the brothers before, I'm looking thoroughly into the issue of atheism. And I'm trying to, inshallah ta'ala, release silsila chains on this issue of these militant atheists like Richard Dawkins and others. Proper detailed Islamic response to them. One of the things that amazed me is that these individuals, these academics that you see, and you think to yourself, subhanAllah, like Stephen Hawking, for example, they now call him the most smartest man on the face of this earth. He occupies the seat of Isaac Newton in Oxford University, right? The Cambridge University, okay? This man's meant to be seen as the highest ranked IQ, smartest man on the face of this earth. You read his book, The Grand Design, and the way that they try to speak, it just becomes hamaka, dimwittedness. His IQ level backfires on him. Ikhwani billahi alaykum, if I told you today, nothing, something came out of it. Nothing, something came out of it. And then trying to define this nothing to be something. Wallahi, I don't have the definition of, what's it called, Lawrence Krauss right now to show you guys. Wallahi, to show you the kind of definition he gives on the definition of the word nothing. Ghareeb. These people, the way their brains have become, because wallahi, they don't believe in Allah. Ikhwani, knowledge of Allah, it's just, when you try to fight with Allah, you just become, your IQ level becomes insignificant. And you truly come out dim-witted. That's the truth, that's all I can say about them. Wallahi, the things that they say, nursery kids won't accept that. Wallahi, nursery kids would look at it and say, what's this? Wallahi, it's ghareeb. Sometimes I look and I spend hours reading this stuff and I think to myself, am I really going to have to respond to this? Do I have to really bring these points forward? Ghareeb. So hating disbelief, the way you hate to be thrown into the fire. And inshallah ta'ala, it's time for the brothers, 5 minute break.